Did the Canadian rock band Rush have a crystal ball when they created their seminal album 2112? If you're a fan of classic rock or cutting-edge technology, you're going to love the connections we're about to explore. Welcome everyone, I'm your host Rapshout, and in this video we're deep diving into a fascinating connection between music and artificial intelligence. Rush, the iconic rock band revered for their musical prowess and thought-provoking lyrics, dropped the 2112 album back in 1976. This was a concept album that told a dystopian story of a man battling against a future ruled by cold, oppressive forces, the priests of the Temples of Syrinx. The album was not just a watershed moment in Rush's career, but also a cultural touchstone that continues to resonate with fans around the world.
Seven females at a Rush concert. Must be some kind of a world record.
Fast forward to our present day. We're in the midst of an AI revolution. Artificial intelligence, once the stuff of science fiction, is now part of our everyday lives. Siri, Alexa, autonomous vehicles such as Tesla and Neo's self-driving technologies, recommendation algorithms, come on YouTube, help me out. It's transforming the way we live, work, and communicate. But as this technology continues to advance, it also prompts important questions about control, creativity, and individuality. So, is it possible that Rush's 2112 was a prophetic work of art that predicted our current struggle with AI? Could these rock visionaries have foreseen our dance with this double-edged sword of technology? Let's find out. The song 2112 on the album of the same name revolves around a seven-part suite that occupies the first side of the vinyl record. The song is a futuristic allegory set in the year 2112, in a world where creativity and individual expression have been suppressed by the totalitarian priests of the Temples of Syrinx, who control every aspect of human life with their dogmatic ways and supercomputers that fill up the surroundings of the temples. The narrative follows a story of an unnamed protagonist who discovers a guitar, an artifact of the elder race that predates the rule of the AI-pushing priest overlords. He learns to play it and brings it before the priests, hoping to break their monopoly over the people's consciousness, only to have his dreams crushed when they destroy the instrument. The lyrics, while sci-fi in nature, are a metaphor for the struggle between individual creativity and the pressures of a conformist society. There's this constant theme of the human spirit persisting in the face of the mechanistic oppressive forces. It's a lyrical warning of a future where technology is used to control and manipulate rather than liberate. Rush's inspiration behind this album was multifaceted. 2112 was created at a time when the band was under immense pressure from their record label to produce more commercially viable music following their relatively poor performance of their previous album, Caress of Steel. But in the face of rebellion, the band resisted, staying true to themselves and sticking to their creative guns, and as a result, 2112 became an anthem of artistic defiance and independence. Moreover, the context of the 1970s, an era filled with both technological advancements and socio-political upheavals, significantly influenced Rush's music. Themes of rebellion, dystopian futures, and the perils of unchecked technological progress that were prevalent in society got reflected in their work. But did they know how close this would hit home in the 21st century? So what exactly do we mean when we say AI revolution? Artificial intelligence revolution refers to a rapid advancement in integration of AI technologies into virtually every aspect of our lives. Today, the state of AI technology is quite impressive, and its footprint is everywhere. It's the process by which tasks that traditionally require human intelligence, such as learning, problem solving, and understanding natural language, are being performed by machines. Think about it. When you ask Siri for the weather, that's AI. When Netflix recommends you a movie based on your viewing habits, that's also AI. Even when social media platforms tailor your newsfeed, or when an autonomous car navigates traffic, it's all thanks to AI. If you found this video through the YouTube recommendation page, in the last 5 minutes you've already been affected by AI technology. We've made significant advancements in AI over the past few decades. Machine learning algorithms can now diagnose certain diseases with remarkable accuracy. AI is powering through breakthroughs in climate modeling and renewable energy. Autonomous vehicles are changing the face of transportation. The possibilities seem limitless. However, like any powerful tool, AI has its drawbacks and potential risks. There are concerns about job displacement due to automation, ethical dilemmas in AI decision-making, privacy issues, and even fears of AI becoming too powerful. It's these implications and concerns that eerily mirror the futuristic world Rush portrayed in their 2112 album, but how closely do they really align? Let's examine the intriguing parallels between the themes of 2112 and our current AI revolution. In 2112, the priests of the Temples of Syrinx suppress individuality and enforce conformity. They decide what people should know and think, stifling creativity in the process. In our world, AI systems are increasingly controlling the information we receive. For example, social media algorithms create our feeds based on what they think we want to see.
You got busted! You watch your poor hub and being fat niggas fighting over food!
Shaping our perceptions and beliefs. I'm sure you guys have experienced talking about a product or idea with friends and then seeing it on your For You page on TikTok or YouTube recommendations. I'm convinced these AI algorithms also listen to what we say and recommend products and ideas based on what we talk about. But that's a subject for a whole nother video. More and more decisions are being automated, raising concerns about transparency and accountability. And just like in 2112, there's a risk of individuality being compromised by this homogenized digital environment. Our protagonist in 2112 discovers an ancient guitar, an object representing creativity and freedom of expression. He learns to play it and tries to share this newfound joy with others, only to be silenced by the ruling priests. In today's world, AI is advancing into creative fields with AI-generated music, art, and literature. This opens up exciting possibilities but also raises questions about the future of human creativity. Will AI augment our creativity, or will it replace it entirely? Could the purity of human artistic expression be lost, as our hero feared in 2112? These connections paint a picture of 2112, not just as a brilliant rock album, but potentially as a prophetic warning about our struggle with advanced technology. While we can't say Rush explicitly predicted an AI revolution, the parallels are compelling and provoke thoughtful conversation about our journey with AI. In a section of the song from 2112, the priests mention that they've which is scarily similar to the last couple of years where people have used AI to make completely original songs. Tools like OpenAI's MuseNet, Amper Music, and others can create compositions that are eerily human-like, producing melodies that evoke emotions, rhythms that can make you tap your feet, and harmonies that can mesmerize. This advancement has opened a Pandora's box of questions about the futures of human creativity and music. The guitar that our hero finds becomes a symbol of human creativity, individual expression, and freedom in a world where these elements have been suppressed. But what does this discovery mean in our current context where AI can compose a symphony, create a pop song, or even a funny Drake remix?
What are your thoughts on the whole AI-generated music thing?
Man, it's a lot, you know? It's a whole new frontier. I came in with my ex like Selena, the flex, ain't bumping Justin Bieber, the fever ain't left, ain't. She know what she need,
all she blessed, ain't. Giving my best, ain't. Does it augment our human creativity, giving us new tools to express ourselves? Or does it threaten to replace us, similar to how the priests in the Temples of Syrinx feared the power of the guitar? The marriage between AI and art extends beyond the realm of music. AI has been making waves in visual art too, challenging our traditional notions of creativity. Advanced AI algorithms can now generate breathtaking artwork, ranging from portraits and landscapes to abstract expressions that would look at home in a modern art gallery. OpenAI's DALL-E, for instance, can generate unique images from textual descriptions, such as crazy ideas like a raccoon sitting in a dystopian cyberpunk city. This kind of artwork is a testament to how far we've come in the world of AI. Yet as awe-inspiring as these creations might be, they also open up a can of worms when it comes to understanding the nature of creativity and artistic expression. I personally initially hated AI art when it first came out because of how it would take away from human creativity. And as of June 2023, I personally have seen pictures of people that are completely AI art that are indistinguishable from normal Instagram selfies. However, I would be lying if I said I didn't enjoy the YouTube short Harry Potter videos.
They say the one chooses the wizard, but in the gym, it's the weights that choose the lifter.
So what happens when a machine starts creating art that can evoke emotions, provoke thoughts, and resonate with our experiences? It blurs the line between human and machine creativity and forces us to rethink the very essence of art. In this sense, Rush's 2112, with its exploration of human creativity in a world dominated by machines, holds a poignant mirror to our reality. It urges us to question and navigate the increasingly complex interplay between human creativity and artificial intelligence. Rush truly foresaw our dance with AI. The Timeless album definitely offers a strong perspective on the challenges we face today. If you guys haven't listened to the album, I won't spoil what happens at the end, so make sure to give it a listen. Bearing in mind our discussion, I feel like you'll listen to the album from a completely different perspective from the diehard Rush fans like me who listen to it without any context. Let me know your thoughts about AI in the comments below, and if you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe. I'll be posting more thought-provoking videos and deep dives in the future.